Hi there, welcome back to my channel. My name is Shelby, and today I'm going to be doing some romance book recommendations for you. So today I'm going to focus specifically on fun and flirty books, so nothing too steamy, pretty lighthearted, and ones that'll just put you in a really good mood. So I have 5 books to talk about. I will link them all down below, and I'd love to hear your favorite fun and flirty romance books. First book I have to talk about is Big Sexy Love by Kirstie Greenwood, and this is the first book I've read by this author. It's about a girl named Olive who she lives in the UK, and she's worked for the same employer for years, and she's very much a woman of routine. She loves her routines, she considers herself a little boring, and she doesn't like to go outside the box, and she doesn't really date at all. But she does have a best friend named Bertie, but unfortunately Bertie is terminally ill. And she asks Olive to complete a dying wish for her, which would be to go to New York City and hand deliver a letter that she writes to her high school love, kind of describing her unresolved feelings for him. And even though it would put Olive way out of her comfort zone, she agrees to do it because she loves Bertie more than anything in this world, even if she hates traveling, hates planes, and going to a foreign country scares the crap out of her. But of course, when she goes, she gets herself into some interesting situations. She meets a jerk on the plane. His name is Alex, and they keep running into each other. And basically, it's Olive and Alex's romance. Really cute. Her exploring New York, their romance. It was a really cute book, and it actually had me shed a couple tears. I know I said these are all feel-good books, and this one is, but it's a little bit of both. It makes you a little bit emotional, but it's also super feel-good. The next one I have to talk about is Can You Keep a Secret by Sophie Kinsella. I love this book. I've read it twice, and it's one of my favorite chick lit novels. It always puts me in such a good mood. So follows a girl named Emma who's in her 20s, and she doesn't love her job at the moment. She gets really frustrated with it, and she just wants to make her way up to a higher position. So she's on a plane. I think she goes on a business trip, and she meets this guy named Jack on the plane. And they are having some really bad turbulence, and she gets really scared during the turbulence. And so while they're having it, she tells him all of her deep and dark secrets. So things about her job and her family and even about her underwear. She tells Jack all these secrets, but luckily after the plane lands, she thinks that they'll never see each other again, and she kind of can leave that embarrassing moment behind her. But then it turns out that Jack is the CEO for her company, and he's coming to her area to visit. I think he's from the US and they're in the UK. So he comes all the way to the UK to kind of do some business stuff, and they see each other, and it's their romance. So funny, so cute, and I just love Sophie Kinsella's writing, and I think it's so humorous. And so highly, highly recommend this one. The next one I have to talk about is One in a Million by Lindsay Kalk. I also love Lindsay Kalk. She's one of my favorite British chick lit authors. This is about a girl named Annie who owns a business with her best friend for social media marketing, and a lot of people don't take her seriously because of her job. And her and her friend work in this little office building, and there's these two guys who work across the hall from them, and basically they make fun of her all the time for her job and never taking her seriously. And she makes them a bet that in 30 days she can make anybody famous on Instagram. And she says, the next person to walk through into our building, I will make them Instagram famous. Next guy to walk in, his name is Samuel. He is an author of a really boring history book, and he's kind of a recluse, not very sociable, and he needs a lot of help to be famous, basically. And so she tries to convince him to do this thing with her and get Instagram famous, but he doesn't want anything to do with it. But she says that if they do it, she could probably make it so he gets more book sales. So he agrees, and they work on getting him Instagram famous. And it's their romance. So funny, so cute, and really modern because it does talk about social media and Instagram. And I just thought this one was so great. And I will read everything that Lindsay Kalk writes. She just always puts a smile on my face. The next one I have to talk about, I don't think it's released yet. I think it comes out this summer, and it's How to Hack a Heartbreak by Kristen Rockaway. I loved this book, also about social media. So this is about a girl named Mel. She is a coder. She works in the IT department of a company, and she doesn't really love her job at the moment. She's been pretty stagnant, and she really should work her way up, but it's a male-dominated business, and no one really takes her seriously, and they think she's just the IT girl. And she's done a lot of online dating, specifically with an app that's like Tinder. And she's had a lot of bad luck getting dick pics, jerks, people who don't show. And she wants to find a way to fix that. And so she decides to create an app called Jerk Alert. And it's basically where people can upload reviews of their bad dates, and it kind of warns you to not go on a date with them. While she's doing that, she meets a guy in her work called Alex, and they start going out and have a great time. But things get kind of messy when she discovers he has a bad rating on Jerk Alert, and it kind of messes with her in-person relationship with Alex. And so it's this app that is kind of helping her life, but also kind of hindering her life. And this one was so funny, a lot of fun, and I just can't wait to read more by this author. The last one I have to talk about is by a favorite author, Christina Lauren, and it is called My Favorite Half-Night Stand. This is about a girl named Millie. She is a professor at UC Santa Barbara, and she is one of the guys. She has three best guy friends, including a guy named Reed, and they all work together at UC Santa Barbara. They're all really into their jobs as professors and kind of workaholics, but they hang out together several times a week and do like guy stuff, like poker and like just eating lots of food and things that are traditionally like girly. And Millie doesn't do a lot of dating. None of them do because they're so busy. One night after drinking a ton of wine, Millie and Reed hook up and they have a little one night stand together, but they don't want to ruin the friendship with their friends. So they decide to keep it platonic and not tell their friends what happened. And the four of them are going to this gala in a few months with their work, so they all need dates, and they all decide to sign up for an online dating site to find dates for this gala. So what do you know? Millie creates a fake profile and matches with Reed, but she doesn't tell him, so you can imagine all the drama that ensues with that, and I really enjoyed this one. It's a lot of fun. I think Christina Lauren's books are so lighthearted and just great romantic comedies. So those are five fun and flirty romance recommendations I have for you guys. I'd love to hear if you've read any of these books, and I will see you guys on my next one. Bye.